Yeah, as you know, urban agriculture is becoming very popular in the United States and in some other countries as well. The first thing lots of people ask me when I talk about urban agriculture is how much food cities can really produce. There is not that much land within the cities. We need lots of land to produce food. How can a city produce enough food to feed itself? So that was my basic motivation to find out how much food can a city really produce. The study that we conducted using Cleveland as a model indicates that the cities in the United States have the potential to substantially increase their food production. Specifically, fresh produce, which requires refrigeration for transportation, is especially attractive to be produced locally. City of Cleveland, within its physical footprint, using the vacant land that it has and some of the rooftops that are already flat, it could reach 100% self-reliant in fresh vegetables, fresh fruits, and also on the top of it, reach almost 100% self-reliant in eggs and poultry. Our study indicates that the city of Cleveland can prevent economic leakage in the tune of $27 million to $115 million annually by increasing its food production of fresh produce and poultry, etc. This kind of economic benefit for the city could boost its economy, it could lead to increased job creation, it could benefit the citizens in ways that are beyond just producing food. It could lead to health benefits, reduction in obesity, as there will be increased access to fresh produce. Just like the organic food movement, where it was about 5 to 6 years ago, local food movement is gaining a similar kind of momentum right now. And every city has the potential to at least increase their local self-sufficiency and resilience by producing their own food.